Yes, Anushka, thank you very much. So let's go ahead and start. Before I start, I just want to tell everybody that please share this with your friends, families, and network, with anybody you have, because the information that is available, you will not find it anywhere. So with a sincere heart and a genuine appeal, please share it, because at least the information, let the information flow, okay, as it is free. Now let's start with Education Abroad Counseling Center, the company which is basically managing everything. Education Abroad Counseling Center started in Feb 2000. The vision is to educate the youth by providing them with study abroad career options worldwide. Our mission is to help 10 lakh high school and graduate students achieve career growth using pre-application technology. Student University Webinars Season 1, 2, 3, 4 are one platform. My Educational Guide was second platform. Third is going to schools and colleges, and we also do one-on-one counseling. So this process, we are trying to reach this mission. We have done counseling for more than 13,500 students. Our USP is that we are one of those few study abroad counseling centers in the world who could do counseling for all major countries, all levels, starting from seventh grade to doctorate, all major programs. The second USP is that we are a pre-application research-based company, so we provide guaranteed admission or we refund your counseling fees. So that is about Education Abroad Counseling Center. Now going ahead, managing study abroad finance, part one. Yesterday we talked about scholarship. That was also about managing finance, but I kept it specifically on scholarship. And today we are going to talk about the second part, which is assistantship. So how to manage study abroad by finance? Yesterday, basically, I told you that there are scholarships available. This scholarship could be basically full scholarship, could be partial scholarship. So scholarships could be of different categories. One is need-based, which is on income. So normally, whatever your income is, if you convert into dollars, you would be eligible for a need-based income in case the university affords. Second is merit-based, in case the university offers. Sorry. Merit-based is basically based on your merit. It is based on overall students' profile. So it is how you are able to present any all your documents, how the admission committee looks at this document. So work on your documentation very well, because you can be qualified for a merit-based, which can again be basically up to full scholarship to partial. And third is sports or athletic scholarship, whereby basically if you have played sports at a state level or at a national level, and if that same sports is available in the university, they may give you some sports scholarship. Then we have we yesterday we I did talk about assistantship, saying that there are teaching assistantship, where you will be basically these teaching assistantships are available for graduates, so it's not available for undergraduate. Scholarships are available for both undergraduate as well as for graduate or PhDs. Assistantships are available for graduate, which is master's, MBA, doctorate programs, so it is not available for undergraduate. So one is teaching assistantship, whereby you are going to teach undergraduate, or you are going to assist to the professors. You are going to prepare the material for the professor. You are going to basically grade the papers of the students. So this is called all teaching assistantships. Research assistantships, where you are going to assist the professor in the research, or you are going to basically co-author the basically professor in his publication, or you will be basically helping in the labs, basically a lot of other research work that is possible. Graduate assistantship is whereby you will be doing a lot of administrative jobs which are available in the university, and these assistantship is called graduate assistantship. Teaching assistantship on by and large can cover one third of your tuition fees. Research assistantship can cover basically full scholar full tuition fee. The research assistantship can go beyond full scholar tuition fee. It can cover your accommodation, living as well. Graduate assistantship will cover mostly 25% of your tuition fees. Now, if you are going to look at it separately, at least they can cover your accommodation and living cost. Teaching assistantship and graduate assistantship can cover your accommodation and living costs, most of it. So that can be covered. So it's a good amount of money that you are earning, and hence this can make the education affordable. also important is people look at study abroad as expensive. It is expensive. Let's suppose you want to study in US, it's very, very expensive. But these scholarships and assistantship makes the education much more affordable. Okay. I have sent students to most of these scholarships are US based. So I've sent students to US with full scholarships. Not only with full scholarship, with full scholarship and assistantship, these students were able to send basically, you know, $5,000 per year to their parents. So that they were sending money rather than taking money from their parents. So it is possible, but then you need to have a profile for that. It is not that everybody is eligible and you have to work on it. So we give guaranteed admissions in case you don't know. We are a pre-application research, so we provide guaranteed admission based on the pre-application method. And we have a Zoom one-on-one session to help you evaluate your profile. So in case you are looking for a Zoom one-on-one session, you can contact your volunteers or you can fill the Google form, be part of the WhatsApp group, and then you can schedule a Zoom one-on-one with me. And I can help you to evaluate your profile to understand whether your profile is eligible for admission or not. So that can be done. And assistantship and scholarship are a second part which can help you to reduce your cost of education. Scholarships are available in other countries also, in Canada, in UK, in Europe, in Australia. Assistantships are also available, but more it is in US, more it is in US. Okay. So what are graduate assistantships? Graduate assistantships are part-time jobs. Okay, graduate assistantships are part-time job that a student is doing on campus. Okay, and mostly in US, off campus is not allowed. So you are doing it on campus. You work for 20 hours per week. Okay, maximum allowed is 20 hours per week. And during the holidays or on vacation, you are allowed to work 40 hours per week. So it's a paid monthly stipend. So you get paid for that. It can come up to basically, let's say anything where about $1,000 to $3,000 per month. So that's the amount that you can earn. So it's a paid monthly stipend. And sometime basically you get a combination where you get partly paid and second you can get deduction from your tuitions. There are also universities which gives you graduate assistantship. Then basically they give you in-state tuition fee. There are two types of tuition fees. One is in-state, one is out-state. Out-state is, let's suppose I'm a New York resident and I want to go in New York University, then I will be eligible for an in-state tuition fee. But suppose I am staying in California and basically I'm applying to New York University within US, then for me, I have to pay out-state tuition fee. I am from India and I want to apply to New York University, I will have to pay out-state tuition fee. So out-state tuition fee, in-state tuition fee is normally less. The difference is sometimes 2 to 3 times higher out-state tuition fee. So out-state tuition fee basically could be double or can be basically, you know, 2.5 times sometime. So that is the tuition fee that you're paying extra for if you're not part of that. So if you get an assistantship, then you are paid an in-state tuition fee. You are going to save almost 50% or more. That's one. Second, you may also be paid basically stipend. That's two. And your health insurance and all those things could be covered in that assistantship. So you don't have to pay health insurance. Health insurance could be roughly around $1,200 per year. So that's the amount that you can save when you are going to do an assistantship. That's a good amount of saving that you can do. Now, I will discuss each of these basically duties. Now, suppose you are looking for, if I have to say this in a song, it is Tara, Tara Ga. Okay, that's a wonderful song, Tara Ga. So this Tara Ga can help you to save a lot of money. Teaching assistantship, research assistantship, and graduate assistantship. So what are the teaching assistantship duties? Well, teaching assistant duties are, for one, basically they'll be teaching class of basically undergraduate. They may take, assist the professor with some extra classes or basically doubt lectures or during the exam, they have some basically classes going on. So those classes are taken by the teaching assistantship person. They may support doing exams in preparing of the basically course material, in basically being there, doing monitoring the exams, all those things. They will provide probably lab support So if there are to see that they, all the equipments are there, all things are on place. So lab support, tutoring students, students who have difficulties. So basically they are told that, you know, these, they can reach out to these people. So these people, those two, the person, the students that are going to reach out, those students are also basically part of the same university, but they are under teaching externship. So they offer the tutoring students and instruction material, the course material, they may prepare in the course material, the other things that are involved and helping the professors. So since these are work that are done, now you have to understand, maximum you are allowed is 20 hours per week. Some teachers may employ you for 10 hours per week. So in that case, it is called 0.25. That is, you are basically employed for a quarter. If you are given a full-time teaching assistantship, that is 40 hours, because normally it is 40 hours. So international students basically doing the studies, it is 20 hours, it's 0.5. And sometime basically it could be 0.25, which is 10 hours per week. So that is also basically will affect how much money you can earn and how much money you can get, or your tuition fee waivers that you can get from this particular thing. Research assistantship. Research assistantships are basically where you would be involved with the professor in their research. You know, this research are funded, so you, the professor basically gives you funding from that, and it can cover your tuition fees. Sometimes students, I have sent students, as I've told you, not one, two, but quite a few who have got research assistantship, which covers full tuition fees, that is full scholarships, plus your research assistantship, which can cover your accommodation and living costs, and plus they are able to send money back home. So research assistantships are difficult to get, but you have to apply to universities which have research fundings, which have research programs. So those are very important. So as if you are going to get a research assistantship, your duties are conducting experiments, presenting the paper, analyzing the data, and other research activities that the professor basically may be conducting from time to time. Graduate assistantship. Graduate assistantship is whereby you are going to do administrative jobs. There are lots of administrative jobs available in the university. Some of them are clerical support, which is general office work, which could be basically you may be working in that department, taking care of a lot of support staff of work that is that the professor has to do. Technical support is managing department website or social media, advertising and social media, providing academic advice to students, those type of things. And outreach is whereby you are basically recruiting, you are looking after the applications that the students that they receive from internationals, and then putting them in a file and see that all are complete, and then giving it to the admission committee for the final review. So these are some of the jobs that you can do as part of your study. And this is good because all this will add to your resume, and your resume will therefore become much more marketable. You will be much more employable. So these are good way of help, you know, not only reducing your cost, but making yourself much more better employable in the market. Now, eligibility and requirement for the assistantship, you need to have a good academic standing in undergraduate, a minimum of 3.0 GPA or above out of 4 scale. You have to get enrolled in certain number of classes. So those are basically three courses probably you will have to take. Should follow international department guidelines. There are guidelines that the department will give. So those are the things that you have to strictly follow. And the positions may have their own requirements. So depending upon what job you are applying, they may have certain skills that you may require. So you will have to look at those skills, and you have to, if you don't have, you have to equip those skills for doing that particular job. Now, how to find graduate assistantship? The main question is, how to find graduate assistantship? How will I know basically there are graduate assistantships? Okay. Now, assistantship finding, you can, now let's say in some cases there are application forms. So let's say teaching assistantships, you are normally have application forms. You can apply early for teaching assistantships. Now, please understand, it is possible that you may get assistantship from starting. I have students who have got assistantship from starting, but those are very few. Okay, so you can get it from starting where your entire tuition fees are covered. Your tuition fees, accommodation, living costs, all are covered, or partially is covered through assistantship. So you can get it from starting, but mostly you will be available after first semester or after to second semester. So that is when most of the assistants will be available. Why? Because in the first semester, at least the professor can know you, can interact with you, can understand how you are doing, can find whether you are best fit, and then they will basically, professor will engage you. When you are not basically, when you are international, when you are in some other country, they are not knowing whether you will be best fit for that particular job. So most of the assistantships are available after the first semester, probably in the second semester. If not, then probably in third semester, you will be able to eligible to most. Now, how to find us? You can fill the application form if they're for teaching assistantship. You can do it basically once you go there, you can search on the department and find out from the portal or from the career service, and then you can fill up the application form. You can apply early for this particular thing. You can prepare yourself accordingly. Networking is very important. The more you network within the department with professors, with two students, you will know that there are positions empty. Once you know that there are positions empty, you can apply for those positions. So networking is very important in basically getting assistantships. Contacts. Now you will have to probably contact the admission counselor or recruiter, tell them that you are looking for assistantship and they will guide you. Or you will have to check with the department, faculty and staff and they will guide you. Or you will have to basically talk to your professors, you know, in a way that, you know, asking whether he is doing any research, what type of research, and trying to find basically showing that interest so that the professor can find you that you are genuine and then you can be part of the research. So there are a lot of tricks and ways how you have to find it. Somewhere you can be basically asking them direct. Some places you may not ask them direct, but try to find out what the other person is doing. Get into the conversation mode, and then show your interest gradually so that you can work for that professor. Also, you can check for university department websites. You can go to the department website and you can check if there are any basically job assistantship job openings. Or financial websites also have this information sometimes. Now, understand each university is independent. So they have different ways of basically communicating. So you will have to look at all places. I cannot say that it will only be available under this section, because independent, every university has a right to decide how they are going to do it. And accordingly, it is your responsibility to go and find out and see if these assistantship posts are available for you. So it could be available on the department website. It could be available on the financial website. You can go to the University Career Service Center and ask them basically, is there any assistantship post available? You can speak to your dean and tell them. Your dean may probably guide you to the person who can help you with the assistantship. Okay, this is not easy. Okay, you will have to knock few doors, or maybe not few, but few more doors, and then you will find a door opening for yourself. So you will have to do that. You know, you can't say that I have applied for, I did for two and I'm not getting, I'm giving up. So please don't do that. Otherwise, assistantship will not come to you. Assistantship will come if you are persistent, if you show that interest, eagerness, and you keep on basically meeting different people, trying to understand where the job openings are, and this will help you to reduce your cost. There are also job boards, which could be LinkedIn. Okay, you can talk to basically correspond with the professors on LinkedIn. There are social media. Basically, the university puts research assistantship post available on social media also. So you can, if you are part of the social media, you can understand that there are research assistantship or teaching assistantship or guided assistantship job opening available and you can apply. There is also a student will get a university portal login. So when you log in, if you go ask basically the career service center, they will tell you where you can find the jobs. So you can get your job findings in your university portal login. So these are different ways where you can find the jobs, and you will have to look at where your university, how does your university function, based on which you will have to accordingly work and try to find your assistantship for yourself. Now, how to apply for a graduate assistantship? This is important. You know, it is as good as you are applying for a job. So the way you apply for a job, you have to approach the same thing when you're applying for a graduate assistantship. So, you know, there would be an application which you will basically, you'll find. There would be a cover letter. The cover letter is very important because here you are going to mention why you want to do this assistantship, how this is related, what skills you have. Okay, and then basically, you know, so that there is some relationship that the employer, the professor, or the basically, you know, will find, and then they will employ you for that assistantship post. You can also get a letter of recommendations from your previous professors, which can tell them that you have a good fit for this particular assistantship. Your resume should be customized to position applying, what post you are applying. You know, don't have a general resume that you send to everybody. Have it customized as per the position. Relevant work experience, show that you have relevant work experience. If you have relevant work experience, it will definitely add advantage to you getting an assistantship, and some ready references that you can provide for in case they want to counter check on how you are in doing a job. Your transcripts, because that will add value. If you are doing good, if you are, as you have said, if you have a good GPA, then that also becomes part of your assistant, because these assistantships are normally given to on merit basis. So a good GPA will help you to get assistantships. Besides this, there would be, once you do that, there could be an interview. Now, very important is basically to be there on time or before time, 10 minutes, 15 minutes before time. Be there on time, because they will look at you. If you are first day of your interview, if you are late, that creates a lot of negative impression and you may probably not get that job. Carry your resume with you. Okay, that's one more thing that you are prepared. Be aware of expectations and how you meet them. So what type of job is available, assistantship job, and how you are able to meet them. Be ready for that, because there could become questions related to that. Research on the position available and on the department. So what type of job positions are available, or know what type of skills are required, and basically what type of job profile it is. Check everything so that when you're going for the interview, you are not caught unaware. You are basically, they feel that, okay, you have done enough research and you are quite good in your basically, you know, approach. This will help you to get that assistantship. And there could be some questions asked. I have written a few questions, like they may ask you first to introduce yourself, and they may ask you how you will be managing the test, because you are doing your one side, you are going to complete your program. Second time, you are going to do this job. So work pressure would also be there. So how are you going to manage the test? Multitasking, because you will be getting a lot of assignments, projects. And besides this, you have this work. So how you are going to do that? Responsibility, how are you good enough to manage the responsibility? Why you wish to apply for this position? You will have to justify that your profile and your goals that you want to achieve are in line with this position, and that you want to apply for this. Your strength and your weaknesses, these are some of the questions that they may ask. They may have, basically, you as an interviewee, you have also right to ask questions. You can have your questions ready. You can ask about your day-to-day responsibilities of these positions, so that they also feel that you are equally involved in what you want to do. These are a few things that you have to look when you are going to basically go look at the graduate assistantship interview. The final is benefits. What are the benefits that you can get from graduate assistantship? One is finance. It will lower down your cost of education. Definitely, let's say if, you know, at least your accommodation or living expenses can be taken care of. Okay. Now, some of the assistantships are like where they cover your accommodation as well. For example, if you are going to work in an accommodation department, probably you will get your accommodation free. Okay. Besides tuition, in-state tuition, or basically tuition waiver. So that could be your health insurance, okay, or basically stipend, or basically they may give you accommodation plus stipend. So that type of things could be available. So what once basically it reduces the finance, you get ready cash for yourself, which you can spend on different things, probably accommodation, living expenses, or for other leisure activities. You get credits for tuitions. So you may get few courses credits, so you don't have to pay the tuition fees for those courses. You will get a learning. You will be able to learn from the professors, from the professionals. And this learning is very valuable. You will know how to network. So these are very things valuable when you're going to do the resume. It will help you to build your resume. Your resume will become more marketable. It will become make you more employable. Professional experience that you will get, because you are dealing with so many professors and professionals, you basically will know how to basically manage yourself in a professional environment. And networking opportunities. This networking opportunity will give you immense benefit, because Let's suppose later on you want a job after your program. These same people will be able to recommend you, or they may recommend you to the particular company where you will be able to find a job. So, and if you are in good books in your professors, it can help you a lot. So these are a few of the benefits that I have basically mentioned. I hope, again, this was helpful.